Good morning, students. Welcome to the geography class of class 7th. We were doing lesson number 13 of your book. The name of the lesson is Antarctica, the uninhabited continent. Topics to be discussed in this lesson are number 1, its introduction, number 2, location, number 3, discovery and etymology, number 4, Indian expeditions to Antarctica, number 5, physical features of Antarctica, number 6, climate, number 7, animals, number 8, natural resources of Antarctica. Before starting with today's topic, let us recall the cross questions of previous day topic. Number 1, what is the size of Antarctica? Number 2, why Antarctica is known as the White Continent? Number 3, when was Antarctic Treaty signed? Number 4, name the research centers of India is situated in Antarctica. Number 5, in which year India signed the Antarctic Treaty? Students, you have to take out page number 135. Physical features of Antarctica. With an average height of 6,000 feet, Antarctica is the highest continent in the world. It has variety of mountains, basins, plateau, etc. Mountains are very high hills with the height more than 900 meters. Basins, fertile land, plateau, high flat table land. The Antarctica has a variety of mountains, basins, plateaus, etc. The mountains are the most important physical features of Antarctica. There are 3 significant mountain ranges in the continent. The mountain ranges of Antarctica are number 1, Transantarctic Mountain Range, number 2, Mount Ellsworth, number 3, Mount Erebus and Mount Terror. Number 1, Transantarctic Mountain Range. This mountain range stretches between the Ross Sea and the Weddell Sea. The total length of this mountain range is about 3,500 kilometers. The Transantarctic Mountains are one of the longest mountain range on the Earth. This mountain range acts as natural barrier that must be crossed to reach the South Pole from the Ross Ice Shelf. Now students, let's read from the book to know more about Transantarctic Mountain Range. Number 1, Transantarctic Mountain Range. It crosses the entire continent of Antarctica and divides it into two parts, that is, East Antarctica and West Antarctica. The East Antarctica borders the Indian and the Pacific Ocean, while the West Antarctica faces the Pacific Ocean. The central part of East Antarctica is a plateau, which is about 3,000 meters above the sea level. The South Pole is located on the central plateau. The West Antarctica has several small mountain ranges and volcanoes. Number 2, Mount Ellsworth. It lies along the southwestern coast of Antarctica. The highest point of Antarctica, Vinson Massif, lies in the Mount Ellsworth. Next is Mount Erebus and Mount Terror. These are the two main active volcanoes of Antarctica. Active volcanoes means the volcanoes that have a recent history of eruption and they are likely to erupt again. The height of these mountains varies from 3,000 meters to 4,000 meters. The Antarctic Peninsula is also an important feature of Antarctica. It is a mountainous and S-shaped peninsula. Here the word peninsula means a piece of land surrounded by water from 3 sides. It points towards South America. It is believed that This peninsula forms the continuation of the Andes mountain ranges of South America. Students, today we have to discuss till here only. Tomorrow, we will discuss climate and natural vegetation of Antarctica. Thank you and have a nice day.